First off, I want to welcome everybody and thank everybody for being here. I am honored and privileged and pretty much humbled to stand up here in front of you, and I'm excited to recognize your teachers and staff and the Rochester community today. Before we get started, I do want to turn it over to Mr. Danhauser and ask everybody to please stand as the RMS band leads us in the national anthem. Students, today we are celebrating the fact that RMS became the 15th school to watch in the state of Indiana. I am lucky enough to get to stand in front of you to be the voice of that and celebrate that here today with some of our distinguished guests, but it is truly a representative of how hard you work as students and how hard and the endless hours that your teachers and staff sitting over here put in on a daily basis. We do have several things we're going to do today, but before we get started, I do want to recognize the people sitting to my left. Several of them are pillars of our community, and some of them even represent us at the state level. So I will kind of introduce each one. We'll start with Mrs. Vance. A lot of you know her. She is our superintendent of schools. We have the city of Rochester's mayor, Ted Ditton, with us. We have two state representatives with us. The representative that represents us directly is Jack Jordan, sitting next to Mr. Ditton. We have Representative Bill Friend, who is also here with us today. We have Shirley Wright, who is the director of the Indiana Middle Level Education Association. Shirley does direct the program, which is to go with the schools to watch. She is a great resource for us here at the middle school, and so we appreciate everything she does for middle schools across the state of Indiana and nationally. Then next to Shirley, we have Todd Bess. Todd is the director of the Association of School Principals. I am truly honored that he is here because when I started teaching, he was the assistant superintendent in the corporation I taught at. So he was part of my growth of becoming where I am today. So I appreciate him being here. Then the individuals in the next, second, and third row, they're trying to get as far away from me as possible, are people who participate in the Schools to Watch process. The process involved us going through a school site visit. And when we went through that visit, the people from our community who own businesses or work for the school came to support that. And so if we can give them all of a round of applause. And we wanted to involve as many students as possible. That's why we had the band back here. So we're going to try something. It's going to be interesting. We've never done it before. We're going to get our choir to come out of the crowd, line up. We practiced it a whole one time 15 minutes ago. So we're going to have our 7th, 8th grade choir come, and then they're going to go back, and our 6th grade choir is going to come out to sing a couple songs. So 7th, 8th grade choir, if you will come up and take your place, please. As usual, our students never fail to impress me. Let's give the RMS choirs one more round of applause. As y'all know, my daughter's in the stands. She'd be devastated if I was to get up here and sing, because I cannot do it. So we are going to move forward with the program. At this time, I'm going to ask some of our guests to talk to you briefly or as long as they want. I don't know if they'll talk for 2 minutes or if they'll talk for 25. That is up to them. I've left it at their discretion. So at this time, I'd like to invite Superintendent Vance up to say a few things.
I promise to be brief. Just very quickly, a special thank you to those of you in the band and in the choir. I am always so impressed by the amount of talent that we have throughout the district, but also for those teachers who are able to grow that talent and to identify that and help support that talent for us, and we get to see it in the most amazing of ways. So thank you to all of you for a beautiful opening to our ceremony. I want to begin by sharing that it's very humbling to stand before you and be one of the first to publicly congratulate you on receiving this very coveted award. I have always believed, and the staff has heard me say several times, that I enjoy the African proverb, "It takes a village," and it is a very powerful look into the reality of the amount of support it truly takes to build successful individuals. That rings so very true today. As I look around this gymnasium and get a feel for the full magnitude of people it took to bring us to this point. Community members, parents, faculty, staff, thank you for being the best village possible for Rochester Middle School students, as it is because of you that we have reached this coveted point in education. Students, all of you, those behind me as well, a special thank you for your hard work and the way that you represent Rochester Middle School. Please understand that you are surrounded today and every day by the many, many adults who believe in you, care about you, and want the very best for you. It is very obvious and apparent today due to this celebration and this program specifically, but please don't forget that they are here for you every day. It is, in fact, in part, their day-to-day actions which allowed us to receive this award. I would be remiss to not take the time to share a personal thank you to Mr. Haas, Mrs. Murphy, and the numerous teachers who took the time to go through this process. I know that this day asks a lot of us. I know that the day-to-day efforts it takes to keep a building going strong, a classroom engaged in learning, while at the same time taking the time to build the positive relationships with students. And yet, with all of this on your plate, you took the time to engage in the Schools to Watch program. I thank you for embracing how important this is to the students, to the community, and to the school district as a whole. I would remind you that as you move forward, that with great privilege comes even greater expectations. Receiving this award does not mean that we have reached our maximum potential, but rather it is a public reminder that we are on the right track and should push ourselves to continue on. And lastly, I'm hoping that each of us has identified leaders and mentors in our own lives, a person or multiple people we look up to and strive to emulate, a person you go to with questions, concerns, and even at times frustrations, a person who encourages you to strive to do your best, not just for yourself, but for the betterment of others around you. I am honored to introduce someone who has done that and so much more for me during my years of administrative career, one of my mentors and friends, Ms. Shirley Wright.
Good afternoon. I love that. And so many of you students just did that. And I want to turn around and not have my back to the band either. And I don't want to have my side over here to the faculty, but I feel like I'm kind of surrounded here. And to the honored guests over here, so just give me a chance that I'm going to probably swivel a little bit when I'm talking to you. This is one of the highlights of my educational career. My background is to be present at a celebration of a school to watch. I cannot be prouder of a school than I am of Rochester Middle School. I just was telling Dr. Bess that the first time I ever came into Rochester Middle School was with Mrs. Vance, and she and I were having a little meeting, and she said, would you like to tour the middle school? I said, I always like to tour middle schools. So I came over here, and Mr. Haas gave us a tour, and I just told Dr. Bess that if I was ever in a middle school for the first time, who I didn't know whether you were applying or not, but I knew this was a school to watch. Even at that time, I could tell by students' behavior everywhere. You were laughing and enjoying conversation with each other, but it was always in such a positive way. Your teachers interact with each other in such a friendly, family way. And I saw so many things in the hallways that were up, posted up about what work you had all done, and others who had come before you who were now in the high school or in universities or at work, but there were things to remember about former students. And there were just so many things, and I think just now I have to particularly comment on the fact that we have a middle school choir singing a song in Swahili. Okay, I think that was brilliant. What a way to learn about another culture. And I can personally tell you, I will be sending that idea out to our other middle schools in Indiana saying, don't ask me about how to respect and learn about other cultures other than putting up posters and eating the food. There are all kinds of ways to learn about other cultures, and that was a brilliant way to do it, and they did it beautifully. So, and I was impressed also, and I don't want to leave you out, 7th and 8th grade, you sang beautifully. I've never heard that song, and it was great. Great job, band. I love bands, and I like the way you started with the drums. I want to tell you before, I've got the banner up here, and I have the pins for all of your faculty members. They will all have their school to watch pins today. But before I do that, I want you to really understand that this designation for you is something that's just not right here in Rochester. Your name is now on a national website called the National Forum to Accelerate Middle Grades Reform. And so if you get on that website and you click on Schools to Watch, you'll find Indiana, and you click on Indiana, and there's Rochester Middle School right there as listed in one of our 16 different middle schools that have been designated. And designation means that you fulfilled all the requirements to be a school to watch. And school to watch means that everybody ought to watch what you're doing because you're doing such good things. And you will begin to have visitors here. You'll begin to find out that other schools want to come and visit you and see what you do and sit in your classes and talk to you, kind of like we did with the site visit. So you're going to get a lot of attention. I just got a lot of attention. So you're going to have that opportunity, and you're going to have a group representing your school, some of your staff members, and I don't know if Mrs. Vance is going to join them in Washington, D.C. I think she is. But the third week in June, they will be, this group will go to Washington, D.C. for about 3 days. They're going to be recognized on a stage in front of about 700 other educators. And also they're going to have there some very important people from the U.S. Congress that's there to recognize this program and the schools that have been designated or awarded that particular name as a school to watch. So it's very exciting when they go there, and they're going to present a session so other schools can come and see one of the programs that they want other schools to know that they do. So, you know, this, you are now one of, and you think of all the United States and the thousands of middle schools there are in the United States, you're one of only 422 that have been designated in the United States as a school to watch. That's pretty big. That's pretty big, guys. And you all accomplished that along with the help of your parents, and your teachers, and your friends over here, your business friends that we got to talk to, and these distinguished leaders who have taken their time to come and say, I want to learn more about this. What has Rochester Middle School done? You've done a fantastic job, and you continue to do it. I can walk through your halls and so enjoy hearing the conversation is just so good, and you're so excited about being here, and that's what it's all about. So congratulations. And I can tell you that any opportunity I have to come up here in the of this area, I'm always gonna stop by, because I always want to just spend a little time, if I've got it, visiting with you. And I look forward to that. I look forward to working with you in the future. And now, do I have four young men, young ladies, yeah, who will come up here?
They're waiting on you to say banner. That's your key word.
Banner. Banner. Where are you? There's a young man back there. This can go outside or inside, wherever you would like it. Okay. Let's make sure we get it. Yep. That way. Now you want to stretch that out, starting down there. Okay. There you go.
Make sure they see your pretty face, guys.
There you go. One more presentation to make. A while ago, you heard Mrs. Vance talked about it takes a village, and I could not agree with her more. It does take a village. It takes every single person that's in this building to make this happen. But there's always got to be a leader, someone who had this vision maybe a year or two ago, and wants to, and really wants to see if this can actually happen in Rochester Middle School in Rochester, Indiana. Mrs. Vance had that vision. And I know that she has been so excited for this designation and for what you have accomplished. And I think that she deserves something, and she is a star, I think, in Rochester, Indiana. And I think you have many stars, but this morning I'm going to recognize her work and her vision. Mrs. Vance, will you come forward? okay?
Thank you.
Let's give Shirley a round of applause. Okay, real quick before I turn it over to Dr. Best and ask him to speak, as I said, I have a lot of respect for him. I do want to give our teachers and staff their pins. And I'm going to ask, I have a group of teachers I meet with every Tuesday morning at 7:15 to help me make decisions or to keep me from making decisions. It's going to get me in trouble with the rest of the staff. So I'm going to ask that my leadership team, there's seven of them, to come up here, and then we'll kind of hand out the pins quickly as a group. So if they'll come up, and as they come up, I'd like to give them a huge round of applause, because this opportunity is not possible without their backing behind the scenes. So. You guys all know them. It's Mrs. Brown, Mrs. Paul, Mrs. Atkinson, Mr. Thomas, and Mr. Bernardes, and then the other two better come up here, because I can't do anything without the two that work with me in the office, so Mrs. Murphy and Mr. Kramer. If you guys want to take a handful and go around and hand them out. So as your teachers are receiving their pens, students, keep in mind the hours that they spend with you. You can probably take that times two, if not times three. I'm helping the math department out here a little bit right before we do I-STEP next Monday. So keep that in mind. They put in a lot of hours that you do not see. So at this time, I want all of our staff members to stand up. Stand up. Please take your pen out. And at this time, if you would take your pen and put it somewhere, I know you're not going to leave it on your shirt, but if you'll put it somewhere on there to signify all the hard work and dedication that you've had to make RMS and the Rochester community what it is today. Let's give them one more round of applause, students. There you go, zoom in on them. All right, so at this time, like I said, I'm gonna turn it over to Dr. Best. Again, I have the utmost respect for this man, and so I appreciate him being here today. So here's Dr. Best.
Good afternoon, everyone. Certainly my pleasure to be here in Rochester and with Mr. Hawes. Spent time in the previous corporation and now with the Indiana Association of School Principals, where we help support the principals, assistant principals, and also do some student programming. My pleasure to be here, courtesy of IMLEA and Shirley, as we help support this Schools to Watch designation. So in a brief bit of comment, let me just ask you a question. How did we get here today? Some of you might be thinking a bus, parents dropped you off, you walked here. I drove up from Indianapolis, and I can honestly say this is the first time I've been in Rochester proper. I've driven past on State Road 31 quite a few times in my travels around to schools. But I ask you that question because I used my GPS, my map, my phone to make sure I got here. You have provided the map of how you got here today as a Schools to Watch. And as you've heard some other speakers comment, that is not just a ordinary designation. It's not something that just comes without responsibility. Bless you. So let me charge our eighth graders. Where are our eighth graders? Wave your hands at me, eighth graders. Audience participation time. Awesome. Congratulations. Now, you've got a lot of work to do yet this year. You're not off the hook yet. I know. But when you go to the high school, you're going to have a lot of maps in front of you. Which road will you take? What got you here today is a culmination of a lot of hard work, and you think back to your sixth graders. Where are our sixth graders? There we go. You think back to that sixth grade year, you put in an awful lot of work, and those 2 years of hard work get you here. Sixth graders, you've had some great shoes to follow and some great opportunities in front of you. How will you lead for that next group of sixth graders coming in? That makes a big difference in the tenor of a school. You have a great faculty here that's gotten you here as well. Follow their lead. Seventh graders, I'm not leaving you out. Where are my seventh graders? Awesome. Looking ahead to being a big eighth grader? Yes. Probably looking ahead to spring break, first of all. But as eighth graders, how will you lead this school? You've got this Schools to Watch designation. People will be coming to see you. How will you lead for this school and set the tone for the next several years? So congratulations to our sixth graders, our seventh graders, and our eighth graders. Faculty, can we give our students another round of applause, please, for their outstanding work? And band members back here, thank you very much, too. So let me wrap this up, because we have other important guests that want to speak, and their words are certainly sage as well. My congratulations to the faculty, the leadership, the community, for getting us here today. Continue that great work. Continue giving us a roadmap for success. Rochester Middle School exhibits that. Thank you very much.
Okay, now we have the special treat, the guys who are trained to be great public speakers. I'm excited. We got the call that Mayor Denton and the two state representatives were gonna be here, and then that's when my nerve level went up and I was like, oh, this is a real deal. So I am truly honored to have the next three gentlemen speak. I will ask Mr. Denton to speak first, and then we'll turn it over to our state representatives. So Mayor Denton, go come up, please.
Wow, how does everyone feel today? Do you feel good? Yeah. All right. We got a dodgeball tournament coming up pretty soon, don't we? Yeah. We want you. The city's coming back, all right? Okay. Listen, you should not only feel good today, you should feel proud. Director Reich, Dr. Bess, Representative Friend, Representative Jordan, Principal Haas, and Superintendent Vance. Very auspicious group of people here today. That means very important and very dignified and who we all want to be like when we grow up, right? You know, that banner that you saw back here, and Christine Seiler from the New Sentinel took a picture of. That picture is gonna go on a 4x8 bulletin board in the mayor's office that is entitled The Wall of Pride. It may be a village that it takes to do something like this, but there are all sorts of pieces that fit into that pie to make an accomplishment like this happen. And a lot of people get involved. And we want to recognize that at City Hall. Some of you know that this mayor's been traveling a little bit to different businesses and industries outside of the state. And we have a PowerPoint that we show the benefits of Rochester and the reason these industries should come and bring jobs here. And almost every one of them will ask while we're there, what's your educational system like? Well, now we're going to have a banner in our PowerPoint display to show them part of it. pride. These buttons were handed out today because this is a core group to accomplish this achievement today, your teachers. And I bet you're not gonna find one teacher any day at school who doesn't have their button on. That's a display of accomplishment and of pride. Now, what can we do as students to add to that quotient we call pride? We can always strive to do the best we can. I read in the newsletter in the green room, the middle school newsletter, that Mr. Haas is talking about the I-STEP test coming up here in March. Oh, yeah. Who likes the I-STEP test? You're nuts! Nobody likes a test, do they? But you know what? You know what those tests are? They're a chance to show what you have accomplished, what you have learned, what this core group of people have passed along to you. It's all about the final line, and that's pride. And I just want to say today that as your representative in Rochester, I am very, very proud to be here. And I'm proud of you students. I'm proud, very proud of you teachers. And I'm proud especially of the administration because, you know, the organization will always take on the personality of the leadership. And as Director Wright said, all you got to do is walk in this school to know we've got great leadership. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Does Jack or Bill want to go first? All right. Representative Jordan, this is truly an honor. Not many times do you get the representatives to come and speak to you. I don't know, I've been this close to a representative my whole life until today, so this is a pretty cool thing. All right, thank you.
Thank you. It's an absolute pleasure being here. When before you were born, in the 70s, Bremen, where I'm from, actually came down here and played Rochester in all the sports. So I probably played with a lot of your grandparents, or against a lot of your grandparents. Maybe even in this gym. So it's nice to see you. You turned out well based on what I saw from your grandparents. So nice job. I do want to recognize three people today. One person that I want to recognize is it's an honor to be here with Bill Friend, Representative Bill Friend. He's a guy that won't toot his horn, but down at the State House, he works harder than anybody to help schools like Rochester behind the scenes. And I can't emphasize that enough. There's, in a time of limited resources and a tough time for schools, he fights the battle every day to try to help Rochester and other schools like Rochester. And he's not giving up till session's over. So thank you for being here. Thanks for all you do behind the scenes. Because again, he won't toot his own horn. He won't tell you what he's doing, but he is a man of integrity and humility that it's an honor to be around. Secondly, teachers. You know, these teachers over here, they supposedly have a job from 7 to 3 and they get the summers off. Let me tell you, that's not reality. They work 24/7. It's not just when they're in class. They're grading teacher papers at night. They're involved in extracurriculars. Their Sunday nights are planning the next week. But it's not just the time they put in. They are emotionally attached to your success. They lose sleep over what can I do to help you, to help you, to help you, to learn math, to adjust to life, to get along with other folks. And so I just can't say enough for how you actually make so little for so much that you do to invest in these young people. So thank you very much for basically giving up your lives for these kids. So thank you. And then it comes to you, students. And students, my son was a band student, and he ended up marching at Purdue for 4 years in the All-American Marching Band, and he started right here. So I would encourage each of you to take it as far as you can. You have a lot of fun. But I want to talk to every one of you students just for a second. I'm going to beg you to believe me regarding one thing, regarding the person sitting in your seat. And that is that every single one of you has unique and amazing potential. Yes, this is a school to watch, but I would contend that every single one of you are an individual to watch. And I would just beg you, please listen to these words. Please, please listen to these words and believe me. You have unique and amazing potential. Your strength might not be math. Your strength might be fixing cars. Your strengths might be writing. Your strengths might be welding. Your strengths might be being an engineer someday. I don't know what they are, but every single one of you are geniuses in some way. I truly and deeply believe that. So the only thing I'm going to ask today is, it starts with a school to watch, but ultimately, please, your students to watch, your individuals to watch, and please believe me when I say that you have unique and amazing potential, and I just beg you to pursue that potential and do things that are beyond any of our imaginations. So go for it, and may today be the start of the next step in watching you do great things. Thank you very much for having me, and I wish you well.
All right, Mr. Friend, you ready? The quote I heard today when we were socializing before the event is, "He's a friend to everybody." I thought that was a pretty good one.
Well, good afternoon. It's great to be here. It's always great to be with a group when they're getting a recognition, an honor. And now you're a school to watch. And you've heard a lot of pretty flowery words up here about the designation and what it means, and you need to take that seriously. And I really want to talk to you about that. But I want to talk to you a little bit about this region, this area, because I represent area to the south of Fulton County and Miami and Cass County. And a few weeks ago, we had the opportunity in the legislature to recognize and honor the Indiana Teacher of the Year, Yitka Nelson, a teacher in Logansport High School. And that's a very high honor. In fact, for the next year, she will get to travel and learn and teach and lecture about how she does it. On this coming Monday, we recognize another teacher from Cass County. Brenda Bowman is the Elementary Teacher of the Year at Galveston Elementary School, also Cass County. Now, here in Rochester, we have a school to watch recognition, which is also a tremendous honor for this area. And along with the high rating of the Peru Community Schools, it makes me proud, and I want to go back to my colleagues in Indianapolis at the State House and say, look, we know how to do it. In this part of the state, we obviously are doing some things right, and you students are certainly the beneficiaries of the excellent teaching of these teachers as they bring lessons to you and the techniques that help you to learn. So I hope that this designation, a school to watch, and I was sitting here thinking about that when my parents would give me the, I'm watching you, you know that signal? You ever have that done by the teacher or maybe even Brad Weaver over here in his state police uniform, if he's watching you, that's a little different story, but we're going to be watching Rochester Middle School because you have done, are doing, and are destined for great things. And it's kind of up to the administration, Mrs. Vance, and it's up to the principal, Mr. Hawes, and it's up to this wonderful faculty that you have, and I mean that sincerely, to impress upon you how important this designation is. They are proud that you have received it because they also received that designation, and it means a great deal to them. So I want to congratulate the faculty. You're doing great work, great work. And I want to congratulate the administration. And the faculty and the administration, they come together because of the community and the support from the citizens who serve on school boards and advisory councils and those sorts of things that maybe the students don't ever see or hear about, except maybe a casual conversation. But when you receive this designation, it is the full package for the entire community, the entire city. I know the mayor's going to give you great plaudits when he puts that banner up and uses it in his PowerPoint. And I just want to say I'm so proud to be able to attend an event like this and congratulate you. And I am very pleased and will carry the message to Indianapolis about what a great job is being done here in Rochester Middle School. So congratulations. I'm proud of you all. Thank you.
All right, and the sign to every good teacher or administrator is when the kids start getting fidgety in the stands, it's time to wrap things up. So again, I want to give a round of applause to our distinguished guests here in the front row. And our guests who tried to get, as I said earlier, as far away from me as they could because they were afraid I'd call them up to the podium. Our business partners, as I don't know if a lot of you students watch school board meetings on RTC4 or not, but or have ever attended one, we get a ton of donations from our local community members, and we cannot do a lot of the fun things that we are able to do here at Rochester without our community support. So I want to give our community members and our parents a round of applause as well. And before we break this up and play the school song and get loud and obnoxious here in the gym, I want to give our teachers one more big round of applause. All right, students, if you would stand up. Mr. Danhauser and the band are going to lead us in the school song. Choir students, we expect you to sing it as loud as you can. Thank you. All right, RMS. Okay, now, I truly appreciate you showing the respect that you have today. And as I ask the leadership team to join me out in the entryway and we mingle with our guests, I'm going to turn it over to Mr. Sager, and we're going to do one of your all-time favorites. I don't know what we actually call it, but I think I wrote it down as Finish the Song Contest. All right. So, leadership team, if you want to go ahead out there, and our distinguished guests and community members, if you'd like to come out there with us, I'm going to turn it over to my staff, and they're going to get really loud in here. I think it'll be all right. All right. Mr. Sager and Mr. Hooker. All right. Sixth grade. If you're a sixth grader, you need to be over there. All eighth graders in the middle, all seventh graders over there.